Hello everyone. Today we'll be discussing about best places to visit in Bhopal. Hello, I'm Roshni Maji, HR Manager at Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited, and these are my social media handlings. Today's content are about Bhopal, we'll talk about, and the best places to visit in Bhopal, which surely you should visit whenever you go to Bhopal. So, Bhopal. This capital city of India, state of Madhya Pradesh, is a true paradise for historians, archaeologists, art and architecture patrons, and of course, tourist travelers. Dotted with ancient monuments, historical palaces, religious shrines, and numerous museums that speak out the tales of bygone times, the place tops the list of tourist destinations in central India. While needless to say, the city is a treasure trove of historical and archaeological sites. There are many recreational activities and things to do for even casual holiday seekers. As you can see this image, it's the same image of Upper Lake, and there it's written, "Welcome to the city of lakes, that is Bhopal." Now, as I've seen in the previous image, this is also known as the City of Lakes for its various natural and artificial lakes and for being one of the greenest cities in India. It is 16th largest city in India and 131st in the world. After formation of Madhya Pradesh, the state capital Bhopal was a part of Shirhon district. Bhopal is one of the greenest cities in India and has a landscape spanning 2 lakh, Upper Lake and Lower Lake. It is a city that offers an amazing, unique cultural experience. So let's see some of the most famous places in Bhopal which is worth visiting. Bhojthal or the Upper Lake. Bhojthal, the Upper Lake, is one of the top places to visit in Bhopal and definitely a great site to enjoy a wonderful picnic with your friends and families. According to local legends, the history of the lake dates back to the time of the greatest king of Malwa, Paramara Rajpoj, who is also known to have established the royal city between 1005 and 1055 AD. It is known that Raja Bhoj suffered from a severe skin disease, and even after a lot of medications, he could not be cured. It is then when a saint asked him to build a tank combining the waters of 365 tributaries and take a bath in it to cure his ailment. That is how the Upper Lake came into existence. Originally called as Bada Talab, it was renamed to Bhojthal in 1211 to honor this great king. The lake also holds the status of being the oldest man-made lake of India. This is the pic of Upper Lake. It is written, "Welcome to the city of lake," over here. So timings, the lake can be visited from 6 a.m. to 7 p.m. on all days of week. There is no entry fees for visitors. And location is Upper Lake near CM House, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. And distance from Bhopal bus stand, Upper Lake is seated at a distance of 10.5 kilometers from the Bhopal bus stand. Van Vihar National Park. Spread over an area of approximately 445 hectares, the Van Vihar National Park is one of the most popular national parks in central India, established in the year 1979. Considered as one of the best places to visit in Bhopal, the park is located just adjacent to the Upper Lake and attracts loads of nature lovers, wildlife enthusiasts, and nature photographers throughout the year. Though the park is actually a national park, on visiting it, you will get more of a zoological feel it. Rather, it would be a more appropriate to call it as a unique mix of a zoo and wildlife sanctuary. On one side, you would spot the carnivore as tigers, leopards, panthers, bears enclose their natural habitats bounded by trenches and walls. On the other hand, this park would give you a completely different experience of spotting the herbivores like cheetahs, black bucks roaming around freely in their natural environs. Operating under the guidelines of the Central Zoo Authority, the best part of this park is that, unlike other zoos, animals here are not brought in forcefully from forest areas. Rather, the animals which are left orphaned in other zoos of the country are given shelter here and are properly taken care of for their daily food and medical requirements. So if you want to get experience about wildlife, this place is worth visiting. So timings, the park remains open for the visitors from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. throughout the week except the Tuesday. And entry fees for Indians are 15 rupees per person and for foreigners it's 200 rupees per person. Location is Lakeview Walk Path, Krishna Nagar, Shyamla Hills, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Distance from Bhopal bus stand is 10 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. Yet another place is Bhojpur Temple, yet another of the most popular places to see and visit during your holidays in Bhopal is the ancient Bhojpur Temple, also known as Bhojeshwar Temple, built in 11th century AD during the reign of Raja Bhoj, dedicated to the Lord Shiva. The temple is located in the heart of the archaeologically important site of Bhojpur, just 28 kilometers from the city of Bhopal. The religious significance of this ancient temple is such high that is often referred to as the Somnath of the East, and pilgrims from different corners of the country travel here in huge numbers to pay their homage to the god. The Shivling at its temple is the largest stone structure in the world and is carved from a single rock measuring 7.5 feet in height and 18 feet in circumference. Standing on a 21 feet tall platform, devotees are only able to access the Shivling by climbing on an iron staircase. So here is the image of Shivling. Talking about the architecture of this Exekuside temple, it was built in accordance to the principle of Vastu Sastra and is decorated with an intricately carved arch at the entrance. The design is in the square shape, complete with four pillars and a huge stone dome supporting on them. The walls, facades and dome all adorn several beautiful carved stones, sculpture of various Hindu deities and pantheons. A full architectural plan of the temple, complete with architectural drawing and still be seen engraved on few of the rocks surrounding the shrine. This drawing have been studied in detail by expert scholars, revealing the fact that some part of the temple have been left incomplete and the reason for the same still remains. National Museum of Mankind. The National Museum of Mankind was established in 1977. In 1993, this museum was renamed as Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Manav Sangrahalaya at the instance of the ex-Prime Minister, late Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Spread over an area of 200 acres of land close to the upper lake, NS Shyamla Hills in Bhopal, the museum is the only one of its kind in India, and is world famous to the house an excellent collection of prehistoric rock shelters dating back to the early Stone Age era that prevailed on the Indian subcontinent in bygone times. Elaborately detailed dioramas here provide you with a deep insight into human evolution from prehistoric times until today's modern age. Many tourists would tend to skip this unique museum, thinking to be a typical and boring kind. But I must tell you that definitely not the case. Interesting, fascinating, intriguing, and educative, words fall short for this distinctive institute, which is needless to say a perfect site for all age groups. And if you are a history and cultural You are surely going to fall in love with this place that takes one of the highest position on the list of top tourist attractions in Bhopal. Here are some of the places. So, timing, the museum is open to visitors for 11 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. from March to August, and from 10 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. from September to February. This museum is closed on every Mondays and national holidays. Entry fees. So the entry fees for visitors above 12 years of age is 50 rupees per head. Location is Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Manav Sangrahalay, Lower Lake View near Boat Club, Shamla Hills, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. And the distance from bus stand is just 7 kilometers. The next place comes here is State Archaeological Museum. This is another museum which you can visit. If history, culture, and ancient art is what that interests you, the State Archaeological Museum, located in the close proximity to the National Museum of Mankind, is a place just for your kind in Bhopal. Inaugurated in November 2005, this museum is one of the most significant museums in the city, showcasing the rich cultural heritage and legacy of Madhya Pradesh in the form of rare ancient paintings, sculptures, and other objects of the historical and archaeological significance. As you enter this museum, walk into the age of prehistoric man and get to see some of the most well-preserved fossils from their times. Marvels on an excellent collection of painting copied and brought from the famous Bagh Caves near Mandu. Get awestruck with a colossal statue of Lord Buddha on display, or armed the art and craftsmanship of sculptures of olden times who brought to life the sensual romance of Khajuraho, a collection of magnificently carved sculptures of goddesses Lakshmi and Hindu Trinity gods Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh, and sure to spellbind you with this magical charm. This is the outside of State Archaeological Museum. The next is Lakshmi Narayan Temple. A trip to Bhopal remains incomplete without visiting the famous archaeologically stunning temple of Lakshmi Narayan, also known as Birla Mandir. One of the 18 temples built across India by the renowned Birla family, the Birla Mandir at Bhopal adorns this sandy yellowish outlook, and it sits atop the Arera Hills in close proximity to the Birla Museum, providing breathtaking views of the surroundings and the lakes. The presiding deity of the temple is the goddess Lakshmi, who sits with her consort, Lord Vishnu, in the main sanctum sanctorium. Beside, pilgrims and devotees, the casual tourists coming to the city well make it a point to visit this exciting temple, which is also one of the top tourist places in Bhopal. This is the outside, which is given a sandy or yellowish look. The temple, it's very big outside, and it's also beautiful from inside. The temple remains open from worship from 6:30 a.m. to 7 p.m. every day. The temple, being a famous religion, charges no entry fees for worship. Lakshmi Narayan Temple, Bhopal address, Arena Hills, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. So this is the location where you can go, and it is just 5 kilometers away from Bhopal bus stand, so you can surely visit this place. The next place comes here is Taj ul Masjid. Taj ul Masjid is one of the largest mosques in India, with the capability to house 1,75,000 people at a time. Its generous size and splendid design also makes it one of the most dignified mosques in the world. The construction of this magnificent mosque started during the reign of Mughal Empire, Bahadur Shah Zafar, between the period of 1844 and 1860. The work further continued in 1868 to 1901 under the supervision of Nawab Shah Zehen Begum of Bhopal. Thereafter, Due to lack of funds, the construction work came to a halt and could only be resumed again in 1971. Eventually getting completed in 1985, the architecture of this mosque resembled quite a similarity with the famous Jama Masjid situated in Delhi. It's pink facade, complete with two 18 stories octagonal minarets of each side and three white marble bulbous domes loom over the skyline of the city, looking completely magnificent. This is the site of Masjid, and this is the front side. It looks very beautiful at night when all the lights are being facing towards the Masjid. So timing, the mosque is open from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. However, on Fridays, non-Muslims cannot enter the mosque. There's no interface from being a place of religion worship, and the location is Talz ul Masjid, NH 12, Kohe Fiza, Bhopal. The distance is only 3 kilometers from the Bhopal bus stand, so it's near Bhopal bus stand. The next place come to here is Gohar Mahal. Located on the bank of upper lake, Gohar Mahal is yet another of the best places to see in Bhopal, standing tall as a testimony of the cultural legacy of the city of Nawabs. It is actually a beautiful mansion built in the form of a palace, representing an excellent blend of Mughals and Hindu style of architecture. This magnificent palace is named after the first woman ruler of Bhopal, Qudaisiya Begum, also popularly known as Gohar Begum, who was not only an efficient and unbiased head of state, but also a great patron of art and architecture. It is under her supervision that this impressive palace was built in the year 1820. The exterior and interior were constructed with great attention to detail and were adorned with stunning design, motifs, and religious patterns. Soon after the construction of Gohar Mahal, it became the center of administrative and political power of the city, and it is at this very site were taken many of the important decisions for a peaceful and prosperous Bhopal were taken. One of the most prominent tourist destinations in the city and a paradise for historians, the palace is a must visit if you are interested in getting a glimpse of the glorious era of Bhopal. This is image, a very huge palace which was constructed in that times. So the site remains open from the visitors for 8 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. every day, and the palace charges no entry fees for the visitors. And the location is Gohar Mahal, VIP Road, Nakkarkhana, Pair Gate area, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, and the distance is only 6 kilometers from the Bhopal bus stand. The next place come to here is Shaukat Mahal or Sadar Manzil. Location in the vicinity of the Gohar Mahal is the 180 years old architectural marvel of Bhopal, Shaukat Mahal, built in 19th century during the regime of Shikandar Begum, daughter of Gohar Begum. The Mahal is famous for its distinctive design that showcased a unique blend of Indo-Islamic and European style of architecture. In a city that was primarily dominated by Mughal style monuments and buildings, the Shaukat Mahal at that time came as a fresh breeze of air, breaking the monotony of the typical architecture and design concept. Conceiving and designed by the French architect who perfectly combined post-Renaissance and medieval Gothic style with an effortless ease in its construction. No wonder the place in those times became a chronosphere for art and architectural patrons. Even after two centuries, the grandeur and splendors of this historical monument remains unmatched in this city. Tourists visiting the site are sure to be left completely awestruck with this enhancing beauty and artistic appeal. This is a huge palace which was constructed by Gohar Begum's daughter. So, palace is open to visitors for 24 hours every day. There is no entry fees for the visitors, and the location is Shaukat Mahal, Sultania Road, Nakar Khana, Pier Gate area, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. So it's near Kohan Mahal, and the location is nearly 3 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. The next come to us is Moti Masjid, also known as Pier Mosque, became its sparkling white marbles floor. Moti Masjid is yet another famous and interesting site to visit in Bhopal. Built in 1860 under the rule of Sikandar Jehan Begum, one of the most liberated women in the history of Bhopal, who worked toward progression of the city by building several monuments, roads, and bridges. This mosque stands as a testament to her incredible efforts and, of course, to the glorious chapter of the Bhopal's history when it was led by a woman ruler. Remarkably, resembling the architectural style of Jama Masjid in Delhi, though relatively small, Moti Masjid is still considerable and important pilgrimage destination for Muslims. People travel here from far and wide to offer their prayers. This is Moti Masjid, and it's very beautiful in evening, as you can see in pink. It's really beautiful. So, place remains open for visitors from 6 a.m. to 7 p.m. every day. The monument charges no entry fees for the visit, and the location is Moti Masjid, Hawa Mahal Road, Chowki Talaiya, Pier Gate, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Destination distance from the Bhopal bus stand is just 3 kilometers. The next here is Rani Kamlapati Palace. Rani Kamlapati Palace was an officially residence for the beautiful queen in Bhopal, who once ruled in the heart of her subjects, owing to her irresistant poise and grace and extraordinary talents. Built around 1680 on the banks of the lower lake, the palace was a gift to the queen by her husband, Nizam Shah, and it is said that she spent full moon nights floating on the lake, adjoining the place in the lotus-shaped vessel. Today, the beautiful palace is plagued by a lust park called the Kamla Park and is maintained by the Archaeological Survey of India. Inside the palace, an interpretation center has been established by ASI, that is Archaeological Survey of India, where one can see detailed documentation regarding historical background and architecture of the Kamlapati Palace. There's a story behind this palace. The story goes like this way. The wife of Gond tribal ruler Nizam Shah, Rani Kamlapati, was known for her luminous beauty and unmatched charm. Local legends describe her as a queen who was more beautiful than a fairy, more delicate than a rose, and more graceful than a doe. During golden times, Bhopal used to be a small village that was a part of Gond kingdom. Obsessed with the beauty of Kamalpati, one of the rivals of Nizam Shah poisoned him, thereby leaving the queen alone and insecure. To protect herself from the ghastly eyes of the rival ruler, and to avenge the death of her husband, she sought help from then rulers of Malwa province. Dost Mohabbat Khan is Lion of Bhopal. Dost Mohabbat Realty helped the beautiful lady and in reward got the territory of Bhopal, which was later converted into capital of Malwa kingdom. The queen continued to reign over the Gond kingdom thereafter for over a decade. With the support of Dost Masjid, some local legends also state that Dost Muhammad deceived the queen, and in order to save her honor, she jumped into the lake, thereby killed herself. So this is the Mahal, and this is the picture of famous queen Kamlapati. The timings: the palace is open for visitors from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. every day. The palace charges no entry fees to visitors. Rani Kamlapati Palace, Kamla Park Road, Professor Colony, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh is the location, and the distance is only 3 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. Now, the next place come to here is Bhimbetka Caves. A UNESCO World Heritage Site, Bhimbetka Caves is one of the most visited sightseeing place in Bhopal, located just at a distance of 45 kilometers from Bhopal. From the main city and on the foothills of the Vidhya Mountains, the place was accidentally discovered by a renowned archaeologist, Dr. Vishnu Vakankar. In 1957 and 58, when he ventured as a leisurely stroll in the area, shocked with the prehistoric stones painting dating back to the period between Paleolithic and Medieval Age, these caves are no less than a splendid art gallery, providing a deep insight into the development of human race with time. Even after more than 30,000 years of their existence, the condition of this exquisite paintings remain intact, inviting hundreds of historians and archaeologists every year to carry out their research on the lifestyle and social practices of early humans during the bygone times. One can easily infer the scene of communal dance, hunting and soldiers and animal fightings and drinking, sparting men from this painting can adorn walls and ceilings of the caves. An interesting feature of this painting is that they are all executed in vibrant colors of whites, reds, yellows and greens, making you wonder about the intelligence and creative abilities of the prehistoric men to combine various natural elements such as leaves, vegetables, red sandstones and manganese to produce different colors of a theme. While there was almost over 600 natural rocks sheltered in the area, scattered amidst thick forest of sal and teak, only about 12 are open to public and are probably marked with number of enable visitors not to get lost in the confusing maze. Just a little up from the caves is a small temple that people often visit during their trip to Bhimbetka. Needless to say, one of the most archaeological and important historical site in India. You just cannot miss a visit here during your trip to Bhopal. So this is a beautiful cave which you oversee. And this is paintings which you can see over there. It's just a glimpse. Timing, the cave are open to visitors throughout the week for 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. And the entry fees for Indians are just 10 rupees per person, and for foreigners at 100 rupees per person. The location is Bhimbetka Rock Shelter, Bhojpur Raisin, Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Distance from Bhopal bus stand is just 46 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. The next most famous, we have all heard about it, is Sanchi Stupa. Sanchi is an important historical and archaeological site located at the distance of around 46 kilometers from Bhopal, known for its ancient stupas and other incredible Buddhist structure dating back to the Mauryan era between 3rd century BC to 12th century AD. The place also holds a great religious significance for Buddhists who swarm here in huge numbers from different corners of the globe. Most significant of all the archaeological recoveries in this small town is the Sanchi Stupa, the oldest stone structure in India, built during 3rd century BC on the order of the Mauryan Emperor Ashoka, carved out from a single semicircular rock. This carved stupa is known to enshrine the old Buddha relics. The eye-catching design and splendid architecture of the stupa displays an austere grandeur of its times. No wonder it has been ranked amongst the UNESCO World Heritage Site. Near the stupa, you will find many more interesting and awe-inspiring ancient shrines and monuments that are sure to leave you captivated with their enticing charmism, The Archaeological Survey of India has also established a museum here, showcasing the ancient artifacts found during the excavation of the fall of the region between 1912 and 1919. Whether you are a historian, an archaeologist, a curious traveler, or just an ordinary explorer, you will love an excursion to the historical city when it Bhopal. Here's the image of beautiful Sanchi Stupa. You have seen many times. It's beautiful. And in this, it is beautifully carved and it describes many stories, which is carved beautifully in this stupa. The site remains open for visiting from 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. every day. And entry fees is just 10 rupees for Indians and 250 rupees for foreigners per person. The location is Sanchi, Raisen, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. The distance from bus stand is just 47 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. The next fort come to us and another historical place is Raisen Fort. Located 23 kilometers from the city center of Bhopal, Raisen Fort sits on a hilltop in Raisen town near Sanchi. Built around 1200 AD, the fort served as a seat of power to many dynasties in the region, ranging from Rajputs to Mughals to Nawabs of Bhopal. It is said that this resplendent fort was attacked 14 times by different rulers, and despite of it, they could not harm the original splendors of the magnificent structure. One of the historical rich sites in Bhopal, a visit here will leave you intrigued with the tales of ferocious battles, jauhars, and bravery. Inside the fort, you would come across ruins of many buildings, including temples, palaces, and wells. Few 15th century old cannons also adorn the inner fort walls. The hills surrounding the fort also abound in historic rock shelter adorned with centuries old paintings. This looks very beautiful when a sunset is there. And this is located in the top of the Raisen Hill. The monument is open to visitors from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. every day, and there is no entry fees for the visitors over here. The location is Raisen Fort, Raisen, NH86, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, and the distance is just 45 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. The next place and most famous place come to here is Udyagiri Caves. Situated northeast of Bhopal in the town of Vidisha, Udyagiri Caves are one of the India's most significant archaeological sites dating to the Gupta rule between 4th and 5th century AD. These caves are a treasure of rock sculptures of numerous Hindu deities and Jain pantheons, illustrating a classical Gupta art. In all, the region is abound in around 20 caves, out of which one is dedicated to Jainism and remaining 19 to Hinduism. The most notable of all relief sculptures found in this historical cave is this sculpture of Hindu god Vishnu depicting the form of Varaha, boar, rescuing the mother goddess Bhurdevi from being drowned in an ocean. The site is also full of Sanskrit inscriptions dating back to the region of Chandragupta II and Kumaragupta I. On the top of the hills surrounding by these caves, one can also see some fine archaeological remains of Buddhist stupas and Hindu temples. If you are planning a trip to Sanchi from Bhopal, you can easily combine it with an excursion to this historical important, yet a little unknown site. This is caves. See over there. So the caves are open for exploration and visit from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. every day. entry fees for the cave is 15 rupees per person, and for foreigners it's 200 rupees per person. The place site near Vidisha in Madhya Pradesh is located in Bhopal, and the distance is only 56 kilometers from Bhopal bus stand. So here come to an end. So these are the most suitable and best places which you can visit when you come to Bhopal. And here is an end. So I'm Roshni Maji, HR Manager at Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited.